Nebuchadnezzar had been humbled by the one true God when Daniel had previously interpreted the dream. Daniel had also reminded Belshazzar how Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego escaped the fiery furnace for not bowing down to the golden image.
You, King Belshazzar, knew all of this through your father's father.
I'm a bad boy.
Yet you did not humble yourself.
Yes, I'm a bad boy.
But in pride you went against God. And you also used the holy temple vessels to your coin.
Then Daniel explained that the hand Belshazzar saw was none other than the hand of God. And it was God's hand that traced out the writing on the wall. The meaning was Mene, Mene, Tekel, Upharsin. And this is the interpretation. Mene, God has numbered the days of thy kingdom, and it is finished. Tekel, God has weighed out your deeds in the balance, and you are found wanting. Perez, thy kingdom will be divided and conquered and given to the Medes and the Persians. Even though Daniel pronounced the judgment from God, King Belshazzar immediately gave Daniel the purple robe that he promised, and the golden chain that he put around Daniel's neck. And as the king proclaimed the wise men that Daniel would be the third most powerful ruler